Okay, so what is the difference between desktop, server and online? These are the basic things, because reader, we don't deal with reader, because the CEOs and the management have readers, and public is of no use for the company, because the until and unless the company is related to NGOs and government data, they want to keep the data confidential. So public is also no use for the company. So the difference between desktop, server and online is that Tableau Desktop is used to visualize and analyze data, create workbook, visualizations, dashboards and stories. Okay, and you can then publish these to server or online or even Tableau Public if your data is not has no issues in making it confidential. Tableau Server and Tableau Online allow you to safely distribute the interactive workbooks to the right people. You can edit workbooks, visualizations, dashboards and stories in the server and online. So you can always edit it or maybe add something new to it. Now, but that is according to the permissions that you give to a particular person. So you have different groups in Tableau Server. In which you are like a project name or a group of people who can access your visualization. Okay.
Okay.
So when you upload it on a particular group, and then you have to give permission to each and every member of that group. Okay. So you can give a permission of only going and seeing, or you can also give a permission of editing, deleting, replacing and all those things.
Okay.
So if you have not given any a particular person any particular kind of permission, like you have just given me a permission to write, to view, and you have given somebody else the permission to add comment, okay, then he can only add comment and he cannot edit it. But if like the manager who is like heading five people, our team managers here in India, will want to keep the entire permission to himself. He will have the permission to write, edit, delete and all those things. Right. So because they are
so
the
basically,
people who...
what is the mean by stories?
Story is... See, you prepare a dashboard in which you have different, all the different visualization, okay? And
okay.
Then, so it is like one slide.
Okay,
one slide that is having a different visualization. And story is finally a combination of your workbooks, dashboards, and everything. So it is your entire entire presentation. Multiple slide kind of thing. So it will have your multiple dashboards, it will have multiple individual worksheets also it can have, and finally a presentation.
Okay.
You can add text to it and all those things.
Okay.
I'll just show you. Just need not worry as of now, I'm just quickly showing you the difference. So just let it open. And also, I would require your mail ID because, you know, see, this is a, because there are few materials, maybe whatever I have explained you, so a study note kind of, and I will also give you from time to time, I'll give you the data set to work on, you know. So you can, of course, download it from the net also, but why I prefer giving you the data set is then we'll have the same data set. You know, and then it will become easy for me to analyze if at some place you are going wrong then. Because there are different versions of Tableau that has different data set.
Okay, so I so just text my mail ID on chat box.
Yeah, okay. Or else you can drop me your mail also. Better, I would prefer drop me a test mail from your site so that I can just revert it back. See, now this is a dashboard. This is a profit indicator of a report quarter. So this is the year and the quarter that I am showing. Okay. And if I change this, my all my figures are changing, my graph is also changing. Did you notice? Wait.
Yes.
See?
Yes.
Right. So this is our dashboard. Okay. Now, this is a story where I have an option of dropping everything again. Okay. And I add like a report quarter figure. Okay. And then I go and add something. Say I add something else. For example, I'll add my dashboard. So that was the worksheet. This is a worksheet that I've added. This is the worksheet that I have added. This is the dashboard that I have added. And further I go on adding and adding and adding.
Okay.
So each time I click on this new blank point, you'll have a chance to make a story also.
Okay.
So finally, when I am presenting my work, I can present it directly from here. That is the dashboard. Okay. This is also a dashboard. So either I can present it from a dashboard or I can present it from a story. I can just open a story and I can present it from starting from whatever I want to the whole, I can explain the whole thing over here.
Okay.
So it's just a way of presentation.
Okay.
So this is story. Story is less used in live this thing. So, but again, you should always know it. That how do you build it, right? So that whenever you face any issues, you feel that, okay, I know this. That is most important.
Okay.
So, I have explained this. Tableau Public. Tableau Public is free. Like I said, once on the web, anyone can interact with the data, download it, and create their own visualizations of it. So, once I have the data, I can do whatever I want with that, right? So that is what I meant when I was saying that the confidentiality level of the data is zero. Tableau Public is for anyone interested in understanding the data. So even the bloggers use it, the students, the professors, anybody use it. It is also meant for organizations, but only for introductory services. So most of the people don't go with that. What can and cannot be done on Tableau Public, because you will be working on Tableau Public, so very few data connectivity options, and you can save your file only on Tableau Public server. You cannot keep it on your system, and for each account you have a 10 GB of space provided. Okay, so there is a space limit also. It has a limit of 1 million row of data that is allowed in any single connection. So on just 1 million data can be added. And so then these are the connectivity.
So basically, yes. It's like a disadvantage of the Tableau Public, like we can store there only 10 GB of data.
Yes. On data. Yes, you have to make another ID and then it's a disadvantage.
So basically, because we are just getting a huge amount of data in the like a big data domain, like we are just dealing with terabytes of data, so it's a very less storage.
Yes, okay. It's very less. So that is the reason, you know, many companies don't, and then the confidentiality is also not there.
Yes.
Connectivity option is also very few.
So it's only like learning purpose.
Only learning purpose. Okay. And some government companies use it.
Okay.
And when we are writing blogs and all those things, then we use it. But who uses it? And once you get a licensed version, you don't feel like opening Tableau Public. And you know, there are some issues with maps also. When you're working with maps, you'll see that there are some issues. Like if I'll show you, minor issues, because I'll ask you to download a 14-day trial version also. so that whatever is left you can, oops, whatever is left you can get a hands-on of that. The issue is this, you know, save data sources. You can save your data sources over here. These I'll tell you what exactly is this. This part is missing on Tableau Public.
Okay.
See, you cannot directly save it here. So this becomes a little handy when you are again and again working on same type of data. You remember I said that when you connect Tableau to a data source, it prepares a temporary file. Right. So that temporary file is, I'm storing that temporary file over here. Okay. So that next time when I connect, I can directly go and connect it over here. I'll tell you in detail. So this thing cannot happen in Tableau Public.
Okay.
Right. So finally, when we will be on our third or the fourth classroom, then I'll ask you to download that 14-day style version also, so that you can quickly, you will have a hands-on of how do you save this and then how do you upload it and stuff like that. Okay. So that you get a picture of working on the live scenario.
Okay. So basically, as you spoke, there is a temp function in that Tableau, like it may not affect your original data. So basically, that temp function is working in Tableau Public or not?
What function? What thing?
Like
that,
as you told me that there is a functionality in Tableau that if you are just working with your data set and if I just wanted to change any data set, so it may not affect your original data. It's just creating your visualization.
It will work for Tableau Public also. Yes, it will work for Tableau Public also. It works for all. Tableau, whenever you're working on like Tableau Public or Tableau Desktop, Tableau prepares a temporary file to work on. The only thing is you cannot save it in Tableau Public. Whereas in Desktop, whatever you do can be saved.
So if I want to save, then I can use a Tableau server on 10 GB free space.
It's just automatically
save up the Tableau site and I just log in it on my account and find it, my data.
And then you can open it and see it from there.
Okay. So is there any limit of Tableau that we can process the data? If I wanted to process to visualize 100 GB of data, so can I get?
No, but in Tableau Public, why will you want to do that?
Okay.
In Tableau Public, because you don't have the confidentiality level of the data, anybody can see your data. Why will you want to use such a big data? Big data, you will only, because whenever a company is using a big data to store their data, that means the confidentiality level of that data is high. The company doesn't want to make that data public, because once the data is public, the whole business of the company is gone, no?
Yes, exactly.
So that is the reason they have kept it. But example, Excel, right, let's talk about Excel only. Now the whole company is doing a reporting on Excel. Okay. Now they have shifted to Tableau. But if now in Tableau Public also I have an option of connecting it to Excel, right? But the moment I go here and I have so many Excel. Like example, this is my company's Excel. Okay. If I connect to this and I upload any visualization on Tableau Public, you can go and download it from Tableau Public. The moment you download my visualization from Tableau Public, you will get this Excel also.
Okay.
So my data comes to you.
Yeah.
Right.
So it's,
this is the issue.
So there is no confidentiality in that.
Security level is zero in Tableau Public.
Okay. So by the security point of view, which one is prefer? Tableau Dex server version, I think, is prefer for the security purpose.
For sharing.
Yes.
For sharing your data. Tableau server or Tableau Online also is very secure. only the maintenance is done by Tableau software people, no, but the it is very secure. They don't
or for the industry purpose, which version is better to working over the Tableau?
For development?
Yes,
For
for
working with
development.
Tableau, no? For development, you for industry purpose, see, again, like I said, if you are working with big data sources, then you don't have connectivity options over here.
Okay.
Right. So this is the best, the professional version, because your big data will have all these Hadoop, you said, no? Hortonworks Hadoop 5 is over here.
Okay. So if I want to use any other data sources, so I can use other databases ODBC function.
You go here.
Okay.
You click over here, and then you have a username and password. Otherwise, you go to Google Chrome. You find your server in which you need to you find the driver that you need to download. And then okay. You can download it. I'll give you that link also in due course of time.
Okay.
That link where you can download all the drivers.
Okay. Because basically I'm working with there is a three flavor of Hadoop. So basically I'm working with Apache Hadoop. So that's why there is no option of Apache Hadoop, because it's only the
Apache Hadoop will not.
Yes.
Apache Hadoop
yes.
is not there. I'll give you a link in due course of time.
Okay.
I'll give you that link also where you can download the driver. I have it written somewhere.
Okay.
So I'll mail
okay.
you sometime.
Okay.
So this was your introduction to Tableau. Pricing, I think you're not interested. Again, the same thing that I said, personal version has only these, and it is same as your Tableau public,
okay.
And this is your professional license version which I've showed you, right? Server online not required. Okay, so Tableau server is an online solution for sharing, distributing and collaboration of content created in Tableau. So whenever you want to share it, you do it through Tableau server. It is shareable. Tableau server users can create workbooks and views dashboard data sources in Tableau desktop and then publish this content on the server. It is very secure and users can see and interact with the most up-to-date server content from anywhere, whether they use a browser or the mobile device. So now Tableau mobile is also there in the market. So you have a software, you download that, and then you can open your visualizations on Tableau Mobile also, through Tableau Mobile also.
Okay.
Tableau Online is secure cloud-based solution for sharing, distributing and collaborating on Tableau views and dashboards. Tableau Online puts the flexibility and ease of a powerful cloud-based data visualization solution to work for you without server software and need of IT support, because everything will be taken care by the server people.
Okay. So
okay.
What is the difference between Tableau Online and Tableau Server? Because they are just doing the same work.
They are doing the same work. The maintenance part is the difference. In server, you have to maintain it from the company. So what happens is, you know, there are multiple times the visualizations are being uploaded, because whenever you prepare a visualization, that means you have to share it with the company, right? So when I'm now we are working on a project, so I prepare a visualization according to my wish, you are preparing a visualization according to your wish, some Mr. X, who is a part of the team, is also preparing the visualization. Now three of us upload it on the server, okay? And then when we go for a meeting, we are downloading it and seeing it, right?
Right.
So we are analyzing it. Now the project moves on. So, there are multiple copies of the same analysis from the multiple people. So, the performance of the server becomes slow because of so many upgradations. Okay.
Yes, yes.
Now what happens is you or else the company, the server performance becomes slow. Slow sometimes because of the server issues and sometimes because there are maximum number of workbooks that are uploaded. Now what the company has to time to time upgrade its server. So they have to so all these work have to done by, if it's a server, it has to be done by the company people, and if it's Tableau online, the head office does it. So the maintenance is not there. And you don't need to have a team for Tableau server then. Those assigning of that schedule refresh that I told you, know, that auto refresh thing. That you don't have to do schedule refresh by yourself. The software people does it. So the entire maintenance of the server in Tableau online is taken care by the IT from the head office, CLTM.
Okay.
So this is the only difference. Okay.
Okay.
Any issues of now? See, this is your Tableau server. This is how your Tableau server looks like. Now, because Tableau server is a paid version, so I have just given a screenshot show so that you get a feel of what it is. So you have how many workbooks? These are the workbooks, and these are the name of the different workbooks that a particular person has assigned and they have uploaded it. So when I go here, I click on it, this workbook opens. Okay?
Okay.
See, I have an option of schedule task over here. Okay. This is the refresh that I was talking about. Okay? Then I have groups. These are the people that are there in the group, and they have a permission written over here in gray out. What type of permission is given to a particular person.
Okay.
And then when I go to content, I get an option of adding groups and all.
Okay.
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 And then Tableau Reader. Tableau Reader is a free application. Please download Tableau Reader also so that you learn. And anyways, it's free, so you can keep it. So finally, you know, required is when you make a dashboard, you feel like, okay, how will it finally look when you open it on a reader, and how will it finally look when you open it on some other device. So that is the reason I prefer in asking trainees to download Tableau Reader. It's a free application that lets anyone view and interact with Tableau package workbooks. Okay, so this is how I send it. I make a Tableau package workbook and then I send it. We'll deal with how to make Tableau package workbook. These package workbooks are created using Tableau Desktop and are self-contained documents that combine the data and the Tableau visualization. So when I'm opening it through Reader, I'm having the data also, but I cannot see that data. Okay.
Okay.
Tableau Reader makes it possible to share your visualization and dashboards with anyone without the need to of them to have a desktop license version.
Okay.
Okay. With Reader, people can be viewing, filtering, printing and understanding their visualizations and dashboards in minutes. So they can view also, if you have added filters, they can do that also, and finally they can take a printout of your visualization also. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So, do I have time? What's the time? I'll just check. Okay, 12:04. Tableau Public, I think you have downloaded. Please.
Yes.
Right. So that's the end of the introduction of Tableau.
Okay.
So this is all about Tableau. I'll I have 15-20 minutes more. So quickly I'll show you the Excel that we will work.